Hello everyone, this is Ankit, your English facilitator, and I welcome you all on my YouTube channel. So today we are going to do class 10 poem, The Ball Poem, written by John Berryman. First of all, let me tell you, this is a very interesting poem. In this poem, poet tells us, actually he teaches us, okay? And what he tells about that this is the world of possession, okay? And everybody has something that he or she possess, and one day it will be lost. So we should not feel so much sad. We should not go in a devastating state that, oh my God, I have just lost the thing. I'm just suffering from the trauma because I have lost my dear thing. This is the life and it will goes on. If we think that, oh, no, we will not survive without this, and this has gone. So this is not the way. This is not the good way, and it will lead you to depression and so many disease. So we should understand. Okay, so let us start. What is the boy now who has lost his ball? So poet here tells us that what the boy will do now, who has just lost his ball, who saw that his ball was going away from him. What is he to do? I saw it go. And what he will do? This is the thing which is so much dear to him. And what will he do without this? And I saw it go. The poet here signifies that he saw that the ball was going away from the boy, merrily bouncing down the street, and then merrily over there it in the water. So the ball was keep on bouncing, it was jumping, and it was going away from the boy, and it was going through the street. So at last it just goes into the water. Okay, so the boy has lost his ball, which was so near to his heart. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy. So there is no need, the poet tells us that there is no need to console the boy by saying that, don't worry, we have a number of balls and we have some other balls. Why the poet is telling us that we should not console? Because he want that boy should learn, boy should know about the loss, that how to overcome from this loss. Okay, an ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy. So the boy is filled with sadness. He was just in a state of grief. He was in devastating state as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down. So trembling means shaking. His body was shaking, he was trembling. Rigid means to become hard. So his muscles become stiff, and he was staring, he was looking toward the ball all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. So ultimately the ball went into the harbor. Okay, I would not intrude on him. Intrude means to interrupt. So poet here tells that he himself will not interrupt the boy. Why? Because he want that boy should learn by himself, okay, about the loss. A dime, another ball. Dime is a rupee, okay, currency. So we should not tell that we have a rupee and we will purchase another ball. Is worthless. Worthless means there is no worth about this thing. Okay, we should not tell the boy that we have money, we can purchase another ball. All these things are worthless. Now he senses first responsibility. So it is the thing that poet want the boy should learn. He want to teach him the responsibility, how to face the sadness, how to face the loss, how to face the situation. Okay, so he tells us that the boy now will sense its first responsibility. Okay, he want that it should be learned by the boy about how to deal with these type of situations. Next, in a world of possessions, possession, these are the things which we own, okay, which we possess. People will take balls. Balls will be lost always, little boy. Balls, as I told you earlier, that a ball is here compared with the things which is so near to your heart. Okay, so we are surrounded with the possession, with the things, okay, which we own, and people will take your ball, and balls will be lost in your coming life, little boy. So here he is teaching him, he is telling him that you should not be worried about these things, and no one buys a ball back. Money is external. So every time this will not happen, that one will give you another ball and no one will buy you another ball, because money is only external thing. That ball just you have lost is so much near to your heart. Another ball will not take the place of that ball. Okay, so money is only the external thing we can purchase. Okay, but we will not keep that ball, keep that another ball so much close to our heart. Next is, he is learning well behind his desperate eyes. So poet tells that the boy is now learning. Okay, slowly he is learning. So his eyes were so desperate. The epistemology of loss. What is epistemology? It is the knowledge. Okay. So he is studying the loss. How to stand up. Knowing what every man must one day know. And most know many days how to stand up. So yes, you should learn. Boy, little boy, you should learn how to stand after going down. Okay. The boy here is just experiencing that how he should overcome from the loss, and now he has to stand once again. Okay, so it should be not the thing that will keep on going for years, for many years. Okay, so better to be learn that how to overcome from the fear, from the loss. Okay, so beta, this poem is so much relatable to you. Fine. So with this, the poem has just ended. So if you have any query related to this poem, you can watch it again. So goodbye. Take care. We'll meet in next video.